name is not Elizabeth. My eyes are not full of tears. My life has not just changed forever. My best friend is not dead. Mom screeches my full name like a fishwife, carrying over the howling winds of the boy, and the magic is broken. Every evening, I sit looking over the sharp rocks and gray water of Limeslink Bay, hoping that I might see Sophie. I'm hoping that somehow saying the words could undo everything that happened. The sky turns a deep state blue as night falls, and I can hear Mom getting frantic. I don't want her coming out to the cliff to find me. What's wrong with Simone? It was Sophie. What's wrong with her? A dark round head popped in the gray water. A huge brown eyes was watching us.
Selkie!
Shed your skin at the full moon. Come to the beach. Find love.
Why would she do that?
Because she isn't alone. Because she isn't like the others. Because the seas don't love her. Not like she wants to be loved.
Those brown eyes stared unblinkingly at us, standing up on the pad. A cloud covered the sun, and I shivered in the sudden chill.
Sophie, let's go home.
There are no blood stains on the rocks. There are no more bullies. There's no world in which Sophie left me. There's nothing wrong with love. Every chance I get, I look for the moon rising over the bay. I watch the dark waves for sign. I listen to the whisper of the tide. Maybe today is the day that the magic will work. I never knew anything about Welsh magic, even though I've lived here all my life. Sophie told me the stories of the sea morgan and the pika, and most of all, the beautiful Selkie who shed their skin in return for love that they can never keep. They get one night only, when the moon is right. She never told me what moon is the right one. Every day after school, Sophie will brush my hair and whisper stories into my ear, so no one else could hear. She said that the wind of the sea will protect me forever, because I was a child of the old lands. But when Brittany and her friend chased us, Sophie didn't turn to magic. She fought. I thought, maybe if I just talked to them, if I just said the right things, they will go away. I've known them all my life. I'd only known Sophie a year. But we've spent every free moment together since she moved here. She's my best friend, so I couldn't understand why I suddenly felt surrounded by strangers. Will kick Sophie again.
Hey! Come on!
Her angry eyes filled with tears. That fierce-hearted girl who was ready to take on everyone. She throws out words that I never heard her say before.
Sorry!
I wanted to tell her that it wasn't her fault, but she ran off before I could get the words out. I want to say I don't care, or you're my best friend, or even I love you. That's the last time I saw her. She didn't show up for school. I thought maybe she went back to England. I didn't miss my last chance to say. The magic doesn't stop with her. It's been 17 days. Her parents had a funeral with a close contact, but we all know it was empty. Some walkers spotted her broken ballad at the rocks of the landscape just after the dawn. It was gone before anyone could get down to her. The tide stole her away. Everyone called it a suicide, but I know they are wrong. Sophie didn't jump. She just shed her skin. I'll be waiting for her on the beach when she comes. This time, I won't flinch.
Come on. Ikaw na nga ta.